First Noel, number 334.
Lord is shown to all of us. He's there for each of us to encounter. Let's take a moment to recognize God's presence here with us. Lord Jesus, light of the nations, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ Jesus, glory of God, Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, God's presence among us, Lord have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, make life everlasting.
Peace on earth, peace to people.
Let us pray. O God, who on this day revealed your unbegotten Son, begotten Son to the nations by guidance of a star, grant in your mercy that we who know you're already by faith be brought to behold the beauty of sublime glory, the Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds cover the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow, for the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you, dromedaries from Midian and Ephah. All from Sheba shall come, bearing gold and frankincense and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Lord, every nation on earth
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, days of King Herod, behold, magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising, and come to do the homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembled all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he cried out to them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for this has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judea, since you shall come ruler who shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly, and searched from them the time of the star appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word that he may go and do homage." After audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star that they had seen as rising preceded them. They came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did homage. They opened their treasures, offering gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And after being warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for the country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Certainly, happy Epiphany. If you haven't a chance yet to stop by, see our Nativity, the three wise men have arrived. Today we see the beginning of the great events. The next 2 weeks, we have celebrations of sort of a core of our faith. We have this weekend is the Epiphany. Three wise men reminding us Jesus has come for everyone. Next weekend is Baptism of Our Lord, the conclusion of the Christmas season, reminding us that Jesus is divine. Jesus is the one who's come to bring the Christ. And finally, the wedding feast Cana, where Jesus turns the water into wine. Jesus truly is divine. Jesus truly is the one being sent. Certainly, it's the Feast of Epiphany, the three wise men coming. They're not part of the Jewish faith, the chosen ones, but they're outsiders. The outsiders who come seeking the Lord. As Herod says, seek him out diligently. And just as they're being challenged to seek out diligently the Lord, may we have the same thing said to us. Seek out diligently this year the Lord's presence around us. Seek in unexpected places. No gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh reminds us things about Jesus. Jesus is the King, King of the universe. Frankincense, because Jesus is divine. He isn't just a super person, he is divine, both God and man. And myrrh reminds us that he's going to have to suffer his passion and death. We see the innocence of a child, reminded of what he's going to have to do for us come Easter, the passion, death, and resurrection, doing these great things for us. As the three wise men came, asked the question, where is the newborn King of the Jews? Where do you find Christ? Hope not only today, but throughout the year, we take time to ask that question, where is Christ? You know, the books that we gave out at Christmas in the parish, Rediscovering Jesus, hopefully there's an opportunity for each of us to look at that question more deeply. Who is Christ for us? Where do we find Christ? What is Christ asking of me this year, this day, this month? Certainly, at the beginning of this new year is a good time to ask those questions. Now, certainly we've had the exchange of gifts, wrapping of all the presents. Christmas lights are already being taken down. The things of this earth are passing away, but Christ is still with us. Hopefully, this Epiphany reminds us he is with us. But are we people who are taking time to look around for him? I think our gospel day reminds us about three things. First, we learn he's not with people we would expect. Jesus is not in the courtroom. Jesus is not in the castle. Jesus is not around servants. Jesus is not born in a nice palace or a nice motel or whatever it might be. He's born in a simple stable. He's not where we're expecting to find him. He's not on the beaten path. He's not a big town of Jerusalem. He's a small town of Bethlehem. Do we look for Christ in unexpected places? And maybe this year we take a look for Christ's unexpected places, unexpected people. Find him in the young child, a little person down the street who's needed somebody to visit, a single parent, an illness, a person that might be in the hospital, somebody's tied up at home. But looking for Christ in unexpected ways this year, I think that's our challenge. And finding Christ in the darkness, in the light. The wise men are following the star, the light of the star. So even though there's darkness all around, they look for the light. And certainly we past year we see a lot of darkness. We look and see the killings in Paris, killings in California, killings in colleges and high schools, and theaters. But we're looking for Christ in the light. Somebody giving a helping hand. Somebody giving a word of praise and encouragement. Looking for Christ in the light. And so the more that we take time to spend time in adoration, taking time to pray the rosary, taking time to come to Mass, we're opening ourselves up to hear and to see Christ's presence, to see Christ in the light. Mother Teresa says, Christ often comes to us in the distressing disguise of the poor. Distressing disguise of the poor. Looking for Christ in unexpected places. Places we may least expect. Maybe somebody who's homeless, somebody who's put out because of the floods. We're looking for Christ in a way that we can serve them. And knowing that we can discover him anew in us. Maybe we're being brought to bring somebody Christ's presence this year. Sometimes I ask the question, Father, what if somebody says to me, they used to go to church here, but don't want anymore? Maybe we simply say, come. Come join us. Come join me next Sunday. I'll be at 8:30 Mass. I'll be at 10:30 Mass. Sometimes a simple invitation all it takes. Come talk to Father. Come talk to the priest. Knowing that we can be the light of Christ for others. So as we take time to celebrate this Feast of Epiphany, let's certainly be aware of ways that we can discover Christ anew around us, but also Christ anew within us.
And let us stand. Join together in the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God. This time, come bring our needs and concerns to God, our Father.
That as the Magi came to acknowledge the kingship of Christ, we may more willingly surrender to Jesus' care during this new year, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Pope and all bishops who govern the Church, for the leaders of the nations of the world who govern their countries, and for all parents who govern the family, may they be guided by the Spirit in their endeavors. Let us pray to the Lord. As the wise men greeted the infant Jesus, may we also treat the young people of our community with great respect and support. Let us pray to the Lord. For all whose lives have been affected by the recent flooding disaster, especially those who have lost loved ones, homes, and property, that they may find strength in God to work through this time of adversity, and that God will inspire us to be generous in reaching out to them in their need. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who are longing for Christ, the light of the world, especially the refugees from war, the poor and homeless, the sick and the dying, the imprisoned and abandoned, that they will open their hearts to hear God's voice of compassion through the people they meet. Let us pray to the Lord. For our beloved dead, that Christ, who came into the world to be its Savior, may lead them through his endless mercy into the fullness of the kingdom of heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are still traveling during this holiday season, and those returning to school in the week ahead. May they be given safety in their travels. Let us pray to the Lord. And for all those special intentions and prayers we hold in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, we're thankful. Thankful for your great love. Thankful for your presence among us. Continue to watch and protect us. We ask that Christ our Lord lives forever and ever. Amen.
As our gifts are prepared, let us sing number 333 in the hymnal. We Three Kings, number 333.
Brothers and sisters, Let us pray to my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands, praise and glory in his name, for our good of all his holy churches. Look of favor, Lord, we pray, on these gifts of your church, in which we are now offered not gold, frankincense, or myrrh, but he who by them is proclaimed, sacrificed, and received, Jesus Christ, lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Bless your thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, mighty eternal God. For today you have revealed the mystery for our salvation in Christ, the life of the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, and made us new by the glory of his mortal nature, and so with angels and archangels, with thrones and minions, with the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing him your glory without end, we acclaim. Passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it, gave disciples, saying, take this, all of you, eat of it, for this is my body, which is given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, the chalice, once again, thanks, gave disciples, saying, take this, all of you, drink from the chalice of my blood. The blood of the new and eternal covenant poured out for you for the forgiveness of sins, do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Celebrate more of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks to God as worthy, being in presence and minister to you, humbly pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we be gathered to one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, bringing fullness of charity. You are Francis, our Pope, and our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters that fall asleep in the hope of resurrection, all died in your mercy. Welcome down the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. Bless the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, bless the apostles, all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages. May I be called to the life and pray to glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and him, O God, almighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. And so at the Savior's command, and for under divine teaching, we dare to pray,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Lord, so I pray from every evil, grace and grant peace in our days, and help and mercy, we be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we bless the hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Grace and grant her peace, and unity in Christ with your will, which reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace, Lord, with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer the sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him takes away the sins of the world. Bless those called us of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion song is number 311 in the hymnal, O Come All Ye Faithful, number 311.
Our destiny day
Let us pray. You are before us with heavenly light, O Lord, always and everywhere, that we receive with clear sight and revere with true affection the mission which you have willed us to participate, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
There will be an evening of adoration and benediction with praise and worship music at the St. Genevieve Catholic Church this Wednesday, January 6th at 7 p.m. Everyone is welcome. Our next dynamic coffee will be on Saturday, January 9th from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. at the DeBird Center. Father Greg will discuss the Holy Days of Obligation and then have a question and answer time. Also, bring your book, Rediscover Jesus. Everyone is welcome. In your kindness, please remember the soul of Glennon Grass and Rosemary Winch, whose funeral masses were this past week. Our recessional hymn is number 318 in the hymnal, Joy to the World, number 318.
And don't forget, we have extra gifts of the Rediscovering Jesus. You need one for a student in college away, or for a friend or neighbor, please take one. Also have plenty of extra calendars, so take those with you. The Lord with you.
And with your spirit.
May God bless us all, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you with us this morning. This Mass is over. Let's go forth the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.